In today's video, I am going to show you everything you need to know to get started in your Valheim journey, including the basics of survival, which includes building your first makeshift house, and after that, some tips to set you up for optimal progression. So let's get into it! So, what is this game about? When you first log into your world, you'll be standing like me here at the Standing Stones, and we've got a raven right there. Always talk to the raven when you come across it in the game, as it has important information on how to progress. You can see here, I'm Hugin, sent here to guide you in your travels. Oh my god, I get attacked by a boar. The megaliths surrounding you are the sacrificial stones. They represent the Forsaken, which you must slay in order to ascend to Valhalla. So there are a total of 5 bosses in the game. Each stone here represents 1 boss in the game. So we can read this, and this will now show us the location of the first boss. So step 2, where do we start? To get your first tool, gather a few wood and stones. This can be done by gathering twigs or branches, like you see here. You get 1 wood, and we've learned some new recipes. And small rocks that are scattered about, like the one right here. Food is also a big part of the game, since it gives you health and stamina. If you don't eat, you will have a very low health and stamina bar, as seen in the bottom left corner. You can eat up to 3 different food items that will slowly disappear until you have to eat again. Try to gather mushrooms and berries that are around and continuously throughout your journey. And as you can see here, we will eat this berry and my stamina will go up. My stamina bar changed and slowly I will get more health, as you see here. So step number 3, crafting. Now that we have some materials and maybe some food, let's build a hammer. Open your inventory with tab, and on the right you can now craft a hammer for 3 wood and 2 stone. Craft this. This is the most important tool for now. As you can see, we unlocked a lot of recipes. Once you have equipped the hammer in your hotbar, we can now select it, right click with your mouse, and it will bring up a crafting menu. Miscellaneous, workbenches, building, and furniture. But we cannot do anything right now, so we navigate to the crafting and the workbench. And this will allow us to place down things. The only thing you have to keep in mind is you cannot be too close to the standing stones. So when placing it down, you see this circle pop up around the workbench, and this is the buildable area. You can place outside of this area if your character is standing inside the circle, but walking outside this radius will prevent you from building anything. And you can build more workbenches to extend your buildable area. And that unlocked more crafting recipes. Okay, step number 4, building. Now we can finally start building. As seen here, the crafting station needs a roof for you to be able to use it and repair the tools that you've made. And from the personal crafting menu, we can now make an axe, club, and also a torch. Of course, the club is for fighting and the axe is for chopping down trees. But without the ability to repair your tools, we cannot get much further. The only thing you can do is keep on making tools, which is really inefficient. Let's gather some more wood. And let's start building a little shelter for the workbench. Okay, so to cover this, let's equip our hammer again. Right click, and as you can see now, we have unlocked way more pieces. So let's select some wood floor. And by using the middle mouse button, we can rotate the floor whichever way we want. They snap nicely. And if you make a mistake with the middle mouse button, you can destroy a piece and it will refund all the materials that you put into it. On a little side note, craft and pick up everything at least once. Lots of new recipes will unlock by crafting in Valheim. From here, we surround the floorboards with a few walls, and we get the thatch roof corners, and we put these on top of here. Also, when you're building a roof, the wood floor is not considered a roof piece. So always use the in-game roof pieces here with the thatch roofing. If your build is not covered, the weather will quickly decay everything you build to 50% health. You'll see the color change to a greenish rundown version. The hammer also has a repair function if you right-click in the top left of every crafting menu. Use this to repair structures if enemies have damaged them or the weather has. Keep your first structure small as well. You probably want to start building a giant Viking hall and village, but you have very little resources, basic tools, and there is a height limit in the game. The colors go from blue, as you see here, to green, to yellow, to orange, to dark red. The basic wooden pillars, or the wood poles, have a height limit of 16, and core wood found later in the game has a height limit of 20. And if we then destroy the workbench, build a new one inside of here, unequip our tool, we now have the ability to repair our weapons and craft even more, as you can see here on the right. Step number 5, tools. Now that we have made a little shack with a workbench, it is time to start building our first little shack where we can actually stay in and sleep. And the first thing you would want to make is a hoe with 5 wood and 2 stone. Craft this and we learn some new recipes. Equip the hoe and by right clicking it will bring up this menu. Level ground, raise ground, and pathen, we want to take level ground. And with this tool, you can flatten the ground and lay a better foundation for your first house. The flattening is based on the level where your character is standing. Keep this in mind. And we just left click to flatten the terrain. After you defeated the first boss, you will get a pickaxe, which lets you do even more terrain work. But for now, this will definitely work. So flatten out an area where you would want to build your starter shack. After you have flattened the ground, go ahead and craft yourself an axe. And now we can chop down trees easier and also repair the tool once it breaks. So go ahead, gather up a bunch of wood and some stones. And on a side note, the birch trees that are standing in the forest are too hard to chop down with a stone axe, so this will come later in the game. Step 6, build planning. Now that we are ready to make our starter hut, it's important to think about how much space you will need and what do you need. You need a fire close to a bed for you to be able to sleep, and you might want another one for cooking. You can cook at these two fires at the same time. And you have to make a chimney as well for the smoke to dissipate. If you enclose a fire in a house, you will take damage and slowly suffocate. So what you can do is build a chimney like I did here to let the smoke out. You also cannot have big open windows near the bed. This doesn't count as a fully enclosed space. So make sure your windows are this size. That will work, not any bigger. So this will not work as a window close to a bed. You will need chests and lots of them. And here is how to stack them nicely. Place your chests down. Then get the smallest wood floor piece. Place it down like this. And then we take even more chests and put those on top. And you can stack them basically as high as you want. I think 3 high is the best for this. And you'll want at least 10, as you will find out later. The game has so many materials you'll want to collect and keep. And when planning out your first home, you also want to have space for a workbench and the add-ons to the workbench that upgrade it to a 2-star or a 3-star workbench. So now let's finish up the house. Step number 7, progression. Now that you have your starter house, it's time to start thinking about tackling progression, which in our case means a hunting. So what will we need for that? The deer at the moment are way too fast, so we are going to need a crude bow and some arrows. These are crafted at the workbench, as you see here, with some wood and scrap leather. Scrap leather comes from boars. Boars are pretty easy to deal with early game, and besides scrap leather, they also give you meat. Cook this on the fire inside, as you can see here. On a side note, while you are traveling through the world, press M to open your map, and on the right side you see all these symbols. We can see our bed here, so if we click the house icon, then double click on the map, we can call this home, press enter, and this is how you make your own map. Also, if you find something like this, there is a beehive up there, but we cannot do much with that right now, but it's good to mark it anyway. So I'm gonna mark this as beehive. And we will keep that for later. Okay, now that we have our bow and some arrows, we need to go hunt deer. And the best way to do this is keep your eyes open and listen to the sound of deer. Once you're close by, sneak by pressing control and you can get closer without spooking the deer. You will get more meat, deer hides, and sometimes deer trophies. Keep the trophies as we need them later on. Okay, now that we have our letter, we have to look for some flint. So go to a river and find flint. It looks like this. And when we pick it up, we discover all kinds of new recipes. One of them is an axe and also this spear and a knife. And also another crafting station called the chopping block, which we are going to need to get better armor. So gather up 10 flint and head back to your workbench. Once you're back, craft one and place it near your workbench. As you will see, they will connect and you will unlock a bunch of new recipes. And then when we look into the workbench, you will now see that it is a level 2 workbench where we can also craft better armor than what we have now with the deer hide we just got. With the deer leather and a workbench level 2, upgrade your armor. Craft leather pants, leather tunic, and a leather helmet. You can also level up your weapons this way. So right now we could increase our crude bow with these materials because now we have a level 2 workbench. So once you have crafted these and equipped them by right-clicking on them in your inventory, you have cooked some food or gathered some more berries, cooked some meat, we are now ready to summon the first boss. You also have to bring the 2 deer head trophies from the earlier hunting trip. The first boss is a giant stag and it is pretty easy to kill if you kite it and stay back with a bow, so you're also going to need to craft a bunch of arrows, I would say at least 100. And now we look on the map and we make our way to Ekthyr, which was shown to us by the raven at the start of the game, so let's go over there. Now that the boss is defeated, you get a trophy from it. Bring the trophy back to the standing stones and place it on the first altar. You will now get your first power, which makes life so much easier. The first power is a stamina buff that gives you jump stamina usage -60% and run stamina usage -60%. So press E to activate the power. And in the bottom left of your screen, you will see which power you have equipped at the moment. If you want to use the power, press F. And we'll have a 5-minute buff. So now that you've killed your first boss, you have completed the first tier of the game and have an understanding of how the game works. The next step is to progress towards the next boss, but it won't come as easily. More tools will be required, new biomes explored, bigger builds in new locations will need to be built. This guide was designed to help you with the basics and set you off from there. So we're going to end the video here, but first a few pointers to guide you in the right direction of the next boss. Base location. Make sure to scout out a nice location for a proper camp. Ideally, you want a location with access to water and a mix of different biomes. The raven will have told you about the next biome called the Black Forest. Also, transport by boat will become very useful later on, and think about this before you start building a big camp is vital. So find a nice place of water, some meadows, some Black Forest nearby, and maybe some other biomes, and you will have a very nice spot. Then prepare for the Black Forest. The Black Forest will be hard when you first walk into it. It's dark, it's full of monsters that can hurt you like real bad. So make sure your armor and weapons are upgraded and make sure you have a base or a camp nearby with a bed so you can respawn in case everything goes wrong in the Black Forest. And while walking through the meadows, you might have come across a dungeon. In the Black Forest, these are way more abundant than in the meadows, but inside you will find a lot of mobs, but also Surtling cores. pick these up and keep them safe. These items you will need to progress later on. Once you have killed the first boss, events may start at any random time. You'll be getting attacked by mobs, indicated by a red circle on the map and a message on screen. A good strategy is to build a wall around your camp with some defenses and a ledge to shoot the enemies from. So I hope this will help you progressing with the next biome. If this video does well, we will make a video for the Black Forest as well. I hope you enjoyed the video. Before we end it off, come join us on Twitch, where we stream Valheim with a fun split screen setup. We give away prizes and we're just having a good time. Links are in the description below. Thank you very much for watching. My name is Zelixor and we will see you in the next Valheim video. Bye now.